Everybody, welcome to Japanese Easy Study Channel. Today we are going to learn about the grammar in Japanese language proficiency test, or we say in Japanese, 日本語能力試験19. The grammar that we are going to talk about today, we'll say about the grammar of 例えば例えば is meaning that, for example, or for instance. In Japanese, when you use the grammar of 例えば, you can use by beginning from the 例えば, and after that, followed by some example. That means if you want to use 例えば, this means, you begin the 例えば and after that you take some example or some plus after 例えば. So to make more understand about how to use the grammar of 例えば, the next let's go to see some example together. For example, 日本の食べ物は美味しいです. 例えば, 寿司はすごく美味しい。日本の食べ物は美味しいです。例えば、寿司はすごく美味しい。Which means in English, Japanese food is delicious. For example, sushi is so delicious. Japanese food is delicious. For example, sushi is so delicious.So in this sentence, you will see that after 例えば, they will take some example, right? In here, our example is sushi. They say they want to explain that sushi is very delicious food for Japanese food. And when you explain something, and after that, you want to take some example, that you can say 例えば, and after that, take your example. In this sentence, they want to explain that the food that the Japanese food is really delicious and after that they take some sample to prove what they explaining and in the case like this they can say 例えば right 例えば this means take sample for example sushi wa sugoku oishii something like this sushi is really delicious the next sample 私にはたくさん趣味がある。例えば、魚釣り、登山です。私にはたくさん趣味がある。例えば、魚釣り、登山です。Which means, I have many hobbies, fishing and camping, for example. Or you can say,I have many hobbies, for example, fishing and camping. It's very easy. So that means, if you say something and you want to take some example for the thing that you are explaining, so you can say, 例えば, in this case, they say, 私にはたくさん趣味がある, right? 例えば,魚釣り、登山。So you can explain to another example by using 例えば。The next example. 私は例えばイタリアやスペインなど外国へ行きたい。私は例えばイタリアやスペインなど外国へ行きたい。Which means that I want to go abroad, for instance, to Italy and Spain. I want to go abroad, for instance, to Italy and Spain. In this example, that means they want to explain that you or your friend want to go to abroad, want to travel, right? So you can take some example.If you just say you want to go to abroad, but you don't take sample, they don't know which country do you want to go. So in the case like that, you can say example or instant, for example. So in the, you want to say example in Japanese, you can say 例えば, right? Like this sentence say 例えば、イタリアやスペインなど、え、など外国へ行きたい。Let's see the next example. 外国、例えばアメリカへ行ったことがありますか？外国、例えばアメリカへ行ったことがありますか？ Which means that, have you visited any foreign countries such as America? Have you visited any foreign countries such as America? So when you want to ask your friends or your box or your family that have you visited any foreign countries such as Japan, such as South Korea, something like this, you can say 外国例えばアメリカへ行ったことがありますか? Or you can change to another country like 外国例えば日本へ行ったことがありますか? 例えば韓国へ行ったことがありますか? Something like this. So you want to say, you want to ask that your friend have a visit to a foreign country. And after that you can take, for example, right?If you just say, have you visited any foreign country, maybe your friends don't know. They don't know or they doesn't know what you mean. They don't imagine what you mean. So you can take some example. In the case you want to take example, you can say, 例えば、アメリカへ行ったことがありますか? That means explain the feeling or to make more understand to your partner to the person that you are talking with. So I hope that you understand about how to use the grammar of 例えば. What you have to remember is that when you want to take some example to make more explain about what you are saying or what you are explaining, so you can say 例えば. The next we are going to learn about the grammar of 立って立って The grammar of 立って is mean that even if or even though or no matter how. So how to use? In Japanese you can use 立って The grammar of 立って with the verb, the noun,non-adjective and e-adjective. But when you use with a verb, you should change the verb to be the casual form or the past tense form. And when you use the noun and the non-adjective, you should follow after noun or non-adjective, you should follow by that, right? And after that, followed by te, which means you can say that te.And for the EHT, you should cut out the E and followed by kuta, right? Kuta te, something like this. So this is about the grammar that you have to remember. You can use with the verb, the noun, and the HT. But when you use the verb, what you should do should be casual form or past tense form.The noun and the adjective followed by that, right? After that, followed by that. And for the EHT, you should cut out the E and just left only the adjective, for example, oishi, right? So cut out the E, so oishi kutatte, something like this. So to make more understand about how to use the grammar of tatte,The next, we are going to see some example together. For example, いくら広くたって駅から遠い部屋には住みたくない。いくら広くたって駅から遠い部屋には住みたくない。Which means that it doesn't matter how spacious it may be. I don't want to live in a place far from the station. It doesn't matter how spacious it may be. I don't want to live in a place far from the station. You can see in the sentence they use the grammar tatte with the adjective hiroi. Hiroi is mean really big, right? Hiroi is mean really big or really large, right? It's large or big, you can say hiroi. But when you use with the grammar with the hiroi, that means you should cut out the i, right? I, so then here we just let one leaf, hiroi, after the followed by the grammar, which means kutatte. So you can say hiroi kutatte. Ikura hiroi kutatte, which means which means it doesn't matter how large, right, or how big, right? Eki kara toi heya ni wa sumitakunai, which means I don't want to live in a place far from the station, which means that even your room is large or big, how matter? You don't want to leave the place that, or the mansion, right? The house that, or the room that is far from the station. Let's see the next example. 今回のテストは失敗したって。また次のテストを頑張ればいいだよ。今回のテストは失敗したって。また次のテストを頑張ればいいだよ。Which means that even if you fail this exam, just focus on doing your best on the next one. Even if you fail this exam, just focus on doing your best on the next one. In this example, they will use the grammar tatte with the verb 失敗する、right? 失敗する、that means you change to be the past tense form. You can say 失敗した、right? 失敗する、失敗します、失敗した。失敗した is mean the past tense. That what you was prayer. So 失敗したって。So you change to be the, then after that you end by て, right? So in this case, you can say 失敗したって、 which means that even if you fail, right? So in this sentence, say 今回のテストは失敗したって、 right? Even if you fail this examination, no matter. また次のテストを頑張ればいいだよ。Just focus on doing your best on the next one. So let's see the next example. この言葉はいくら調べたって辞書には出てこないだ。この言葉はいくら調べたって辞書には出てこないだ。Which means that no matter how hard I try to look up this word, it won't show up in the dictionary. No matter how hard I try to look up this word, it won't show up in the dictionary. In this sentence, we see that they use the verb 調べる, right? 調べる, with the grammar of 立て. But when change the 調べる to be the past tense, it can be 調べました、調べた, right? But in this case, they use 調べた, and after that followed by て, so you can say 調べたって、 which means how matter, no matter how hard I try to look or I try to search, something like this. So in this sentence, say この言葉はいくら調べたって 辞書には出てこない。Which means how this word read. No matter how hard I try to look up this word, it won't show up in the dictionary. Next example. あんないい男は世界中どこを探したっていないだぞ。あんないい男は世界中どこを探したっていないだぞ。Which means that even if you search, there aren't many great guys like that out there. Even if you search, there aren't many great guys like that out there. We can see in this sentence that they use the verb sagasu. Sagasu, when you change to be the past tense, can change like sagashita. Right? So in the case sagashita, so after that you end by or you follow by de, which means sagashita de. It had a meaning that even if you search, right, no matter how hard you do something like that. So in this sentence that means that even if you search, there aren't many great guys like that out there. あんないい男は世界中どこを探したって、right, which means even if you search, there aren't many great guys like that out there. The next we are going to learn about the grammar of te bakari iru. The grammar of te bakari iru is mean that only or nothing but something. In Japanese, when you use the grammar of te bakari iru, that means you can use the verb only. But when you use the verb, you should change the verb to be the te form. You cannot use in dictionary form, in mass form. You cannot. You can use it only with the te form. That means you should change the verb to the te form. For example, taberu should change to be tabete, right? Tabete, and after that followed by bakari. And it has the meaning that only, or do, or nothing but, or something. For example, you can say 食べてばかりいる, right? This means do nothing but eat only, something like this. So let's go to see example together to make more understand. The first example, この猫は寝てばかりいります。この猫は寝てばかりいます。Which means that this cat does nothing but sleep. This cat does nothing but sleep. In this sentence, we'll see that they say they use the grammar with the verb 寝る. But when you use with the grammar ばかり이르, then you should change to be the day form. So you can say 寝てばかりいます. Right? ばかりいる or います, it just had the same meaning. いる, this means the dictionary form, but います is the mass form. So you can say ばかりいます or ばかりいる, just had the same meaning. So don't be confused. この猫は寝てばかりいます. That means this cat does nothing but sleep only. Next example. あの子が泣いてばかりいる。あの子が泣いてばかりいる。Which means that child does nothing but cry. Which means cry only does nothing. That child does nothing but cry. In this sentence, they use the grammar てばかりいる with the verb 泣く, right? 泣く is mean cry.Mas for nakimas, but therefore you should change to be like naite, right? Naite bakari iru, or you can say naite bakari imasu in the polite form right yeah polite form is mean naite bakari imasu but in the dictionary form naite bakari iru that mean that child does nothing but cry only so when you use with the te bakari iru or te bakari imasu you should use with the something that do only one thing for example eat only or sleeping only or driving only or talking only something like this the example 甘いものを食べてばかりいると太りますよ甘いものを食べてばかりいると太りますよ Which means that if you keep only eating sweets, you are going to gain weight. If you keep only eating sweets, you are going to gain weight. It is intended to say they use the grammar te bakari with the verb taberu. Taberu or taberimasu is mean that eat.So we change the telephone can say tabete bakari iru. This means you eat only, right? So amai mono is mean sweet thing, right? Sweet thing. For example, cake or candy, right? Something like this. Amai mono o tabete bakari iru to, which means if you keep only eating sweets, futoi limasu yo.You are going to gain weight, so you get more weight. You get more, not that good for your health. Right? The next example, テレビを見てばかりいると目が悪くなりますよ。テレビを見てばかりいると目が悪くなりますよ。Which means that if you keep watching TV all the time, your eyes are going to be bad. If you keep watching TV all the time, your eyes are going to be bad. In this case, we see that they use the grammar te bakari iru with the verb miru or mimasu, which means look or watch.So change to be the day form can say mite right after the flow by bakari iru can say mite bakari iru to nani o miru desu ka what do you watch this mean telebi o mite iru bakari to this mean if you keep watching TV only right or all the time right? every time in the morning eveningin the afternoon right so you it's not good for your eyes so they can say 目が悪くなりますよ which means your eyes are going to be bad thank you very much for watching my video clip and please help me subscribe my channel if you haven't I hope to see you about learning Japanese in the next video clip ありがとうございました